Well, how are you doing today?
I'm doing really good. Almost in Chicago.
Almost in Chicago. Okay, last time you put out an album, you guys toured like crazy. Do you see effects of it?
Yes, because we're touring like crazy again.
But do you see more people turning up?
Yes. It's working. Our evil plan has come to its fruition.
Okay. And now you even went to Australia, which is almost unheard of by today's standards. What was that like?
It was crazy, actually. There's a big metal scene in Australia. We were lucky enough that Century Media gives us the support that we were able to go there, because really, to become more popular in Australia, you need to tour there.
Obviously, that's right.
And already that's paying off, because the new record is doing much better than the last one did in Australia, as it is everywhere. So the touring is paying off.
Did you get to experience anything unusual in Australia, like, you know, the animals they have?
I fucked a kangaroo, actually.
Okay. That could be one.
Man, you know, those things can buck, I'll tell you. Anyway, no, I'm kidding, obviously. But
okay.
Australia was cool. I mean, the people there were so nice, and everybody and everyone, everything about it was just the coolest experience. So
excellent. Now, when you guys tour for so long, what do you do on the road? I mean, you only play for 1 hour, but what happened to the other 23 hours?
A whole lot of sitting around waiting.
So how do you amuse yourself to stay
sane? Music, movies, video games.
Got it. Last time we spoke, you mentioned a cover album. What happened to that?
Every band in the world did a cover album, and so then we decided it was not a good idea to do a cover album.
Mm-hmm. Okay, how is Jim doing with his fingers? Last time I saw him, he looked like he was about to...
Get him to show it to you.
he left already.
It's still a little bit screwed up, but I mean, it's working now. The doctors told him he wasn't going to be able to use it for like a year, and he proved them wrong, but it's still kind of... It still gives him some trouble, but at least he's still got his finger.
That's good. When you began working on a new album, how did you want it to sound this time? Do you just follow a formula, or you just kind of let it flow?
Jeff, would you like to answer that question? Jeff is hiding in the shadows, refusing to speak to you.
Yes.
Just say hello, Jeff.
Hello.
Say it louder, they can't hear you.
Hello.
Okay.
All right.
We just wanted it to be a massive wall of guitars, brutal and in your face, and that's what we got.
Now,
didn't we, Jeff?
As far as progression goes, are you guys still kind of searching for that perfect sound, or you think you found one with the last one?
I don't know. You know, the thing about Nevermore, I think, is that we tend to change our sound with each record, so I don't think that there's ever going to be one particular sound that will be us. Although there's a common element in each one of our records, I think we're always trying to expand and just grow and become more than we never were before.
So, you know, as a contrast,
that was
how
really
would you compare
stupid.
The new album to your previous album?
Wasn't it, Jeff? What?
How would you compare the new album to your previous releases?
It's the newer one.
That's sound-wise, music-wise?
I think that it's basic. Help me.
Who needs help?
You got a sore throat? Anyway, it's just, I think, for us, one step farther in the progression of our musical evolution. So, who knows where we're going after this? I don't know.
Got it.
We're just getting heavier all the time, so. You can only get so heavy, though. I don't know, you know, I don't know how we can get heavier at this point.
Does that mean you're going to be like Mayhem in a few albums?
No,
on a serious note. It comes to me as a surprise that Neil Kernan wasn't involved when just about anything else you've done with him. So how come he was not included this time, and why Andy Sneap?
We wanted Andy for one particular reason, because we wanted a fresh perspective, a fresh pair of ears to interpret our sound and put it onto tape. And we made the decision not because we were unhappy with Neil Kernan, because we never were. I mean, he still remains a good friend, and you know, we may work with him again in the future, we don't know at this point. But we knew that we were at the point in our careers where we wanted to take kind of a bold step. And we knew that this record was going to be really guitar-oriented. And Andy Sneap being
a guitar player
himself, I mean, he was just the logical choice at that point.
What do you think he gave Nevermore? Or
he gave us a fucking brutal sound, is what he did.
Can you explain the title Dead Heart in a Dead World in relation to the songs on the album?
No, I can't. I think that a lot of the stuff that I'm writing, especially within the lyrics, it's meant to be kind of subjective, and it's not supposed to be real literal. Because for me, if I explain exactly what I'm saying in these songs, it kind of takes the mystery out of it for people, and I would like for people to listen to the songs, and you know, if one person gets something out of it, maybe another person takes something else completely differently. And I mean, it's meant to be that way, so I don't like to really explain things in literal terms.
So basically, you like to leave that area to be explored.
Exactly.
And interpreted. Good. What are your personal favorite moments of the album?
The guitar solo in Engines of Hate.
Okay, that says it all. Now, as far as your record label going, how are they promoting this album this time? After all, it's what, fifth release, I believe?
So after we flogged them with the Dead Tuna Fish, they finally started putting money into it, yeah.
And
they're doing good.
So. From what I hear, you have a video available this
Yes,
time.
We do.
So for what song then?
It's Believe in Nothing, which was not our choice.
Okay.
But the video turned out really good.
Is that a concept or just live performance?
It's a conceptual piece.
Okay. And we're definitely going to see it with this interview.
Are you?
Yes.
It's not done yet, though.
But
we've got the rough version, but we haven't even seen the finished product yet, but it looks really good.
Okay. Hopefully the viewers will appreciate it as well. Now, Daryl, on a personal note, you sound fantastic, you know, as far as singing goes for many years now. How do you go about maintaining your voice?
Tequila and LSD.
any other
things? Massive amounts of both. No, obviously I'm kidding. I don't know. I mean, I took a lot of voice training when I was starting out early, so I learned how to not damage my voice. So.
What about if you, let's say, get a cold, or that's the case?
Yeah, well.
How do you work with that?
You drink a lot of hot tea, take a lot of cough drops, and pray. No, I would never do that, actually. But
obviously, there's one person less in the band, Tim Calvert. Who kidnapped him?
Boeing.
A Belgian waffle. Boeing. I don't really know what to say about that, to tell you the truth.
But he's no longer with the band.
No, he's not. He recently became married, and I think he's probably happier staying at home and being with his wife.
Now,
and we wish him all the luck in the world, and you know, we don't have any bad feelings toward him.
Tim was a cool guy.
Hopefully he doesn't towards us.
Will you continue as a four-piece, or will you have another guitar player?
Yes, we're continuing right now as a four-piece, but we have a guitar player that's going to be touring with us.
Okay.
Given the kind of curse that we've had in the past, we're kind of, you know, being careful about getting someone permanent in the band, so. We'll give it a few years, see what happens with this guy. But for right now, I mean, he's an amazing live performer. You'll see that tonight.
Finally, when will we finally get a live album from Nevermore?
Never.
Don't you think it's about time?
No.
Why are you so anti-live album?
Because they're never live.
That's true. I guess you could break that pattern.
I mean. Yeah, if we do ever do a live record, it will be live, and it'll probably sound like shit, so. What?
That's it.
Okay.
Thank you for talking to us.
Into a strange new world. Into